This is another weather update, and this is your latest and last forecast before the severe weather we're expecting tomorrow into Iowa, Missouri, Nebraska, the central Midwest regions. We are expecting some severe weather, so let's get right into the video here. We are talking about the severe weather outbreak here in Iowa and northern Missouri as we go into Saturday tomorrow. Looking here at Saturday midday, we do see some rain and some stronger thunderstorms going through Waterloo here into northern Iowa. We could see a little, some claps of thunder and some a little hail there, but that's not our main course. We do see around 2 mid-afternoon here, we do see that first line of storms come through Iowa south of Des Moines. We could be seeing some pretty strong storms, mainly a damaging wind threat with this first line, but then our eyes mainly shift over here to the second line, which is really what I call the main course of this severe weather. We do see some pretty big storms pop up behind this line of storms. Those could become tornadic, so we are going to have to watch that. As if this does come into fruition, some of these storms could become tornadic, as we do have a 5% tornado risk. So the tornado risk is there. There could be some tornadoes. Now, I'm not saying this is going to be some crazy severe weather outbreak or tornado outbreak like we had on December 10th, but still something really to watch here. As we go into 5, 6 p.m., this does go through Fort Dodge, Ames, and Des Moines. Some strong storms here. Embedded supercells could become tornadic. You can see isolated embedded storms become tornadic in this strong line of storms. It does go through St. Joseph around 6, 7 p.m. Some pretty strong storms there. This does go off to the east into an area like Ottumwa and Cedar Rapids around 9, 10 p.m. But as we go into, let's say, 10, 11 p.m. here, these do kind of weaken out as they go off to into the east, into some of the bigger cities like Chicago and St. Louis, but it does weaken off. But a quick rewind here, we have that first line of storms coming in around 1, 2 p.m. Then right after that, forming in Nebraska, we see that second line coming through Omaha around 3 p.m., and that does truck across the strait that the state there, and we could be expecting some strong damaging winds and isolated tornadoes with this. So along with the wind threat, we also, again, like I said, have a tornado threat here, especially as we go into Saturday into, you know, mid to late afternoon. We do see this is kind of the tornado parameter here, tells us the chances for a tornado here. So 1 to 2, maybe some isolated spots where there could be chances for tornado according to the parameter here. And as that goes off to the east, again, it weakens. But especially over here in western Iowa and eastern Nebraska, that's where we're expecting our greatest chance for tornadoes with that strong line of storms. And as well with the tornadoes, with the severe weather, again, chance for tornadoes, but mostly just some damaging winds. We do also have some snow with this, as you can see in the Nebraska, South Dakota, Minnesota, northern Wisconsin, and the north, extreme northern UP, Michigan. We do have a pretty big strip here of 3 to 6 inches. Some isolated spots could get 6 to 12, especially in those higher elevations of Wyoming into northern Colorado. And as this goes into Canada, we could see those even bigger totals of up to 1.5 feet here. And also an overlooked detail of the storm is the ice threat. We do have over 1/4 inch possible here into extreme northern Nebraska, parts of southern South Dakota, Minnesota, northern Wisconsin, the UP of Michigan, and especially into Canada here. 1/4 inch or ice is likely going to be happening here, and that could cause power outages. So start getting prepared if you're in these blue regions, those places that are going to get 1/4 to 3/4 inch. There's going to be some pretty good, some pretty big threats there for that ice. So make sure you're prepared for that if you're in those areas here. And then looking here at the Storm Prediction Center's put out, we do have a slight risk for most of the state of Iowa, southern Minnesota here, and western Wisconsin, especially northern Missouri, St. Joseph, Kansas City, and that marginal risk, Des Moines, especially all throughout Iowa. We are expecting some pretty significant storms going through the state and northern Missouri, expecting the strong storms. We do have a 5% chance of tornadoes here. So again, some embedded supercells there in that line of storms that could become tornadic. And then behind that line, where if we do see those isolated supercells behind that line, that's where we could see some other storms that do become tornadic, because they have the right ingredients. They're not in that line there by themselves, so they have a greater chance of becoming tornadic here. And then we do have, again, that 15% wind threat, going to be a pretty good wind threat as this does go through Iowa and northern Missouri. And then also the hail threat, as some of these storms could drop some pretty good hail because they are going to be pretty strong storms. And then we are going to get into tomorrow's outlook to as we go into future updates. Probably an update tomorrow. I'm going to be talking about Sunday into Monday's outlook. But we already do have a slight risk here for Little Rock. Most of central and northern Arkansas here into eastern and northeastern Texas, we are expecting that slight risk. So just remember, we do have that that severe weather here in Iowa for tomorrow, and then Sunday into Monday, we do have that slight risk again. So a lot of severe weather, a lot of stuff to talk about. I'll get into this as we go into the next video, but that's your latest weather update on the upcoming snow, ice, and big severe weather threat. If this does get bad enough, there's a chance, I'm not promising, but a chance I do go live. And if you want to be kept updated on this, subscribe and go follow me on Twitter for the latest updates. Link will be in the description, and I'll see you in the next weather update.